shit! Always land on our feet, my ass. Hey guys, welcome back. You know, I'm not going to waste any of your time, so right now, we're going to pounce right back into this thing and hopefully end on a high note.
Kotsky waits for Misai at the gate all morning again. Seriously, this kid needs a hobby. Until he runs into Misai's friends, who flip pretty fast on the whole Igarashi situation.
Misai didn't come to school today.
Yeah, she called Saki this morning and said she had a cold.
Yeah, and I'm a cat. Keep going.
I see. So he turned her down.
Poor Misai.
As much as I hate to see Misai get her heart broken, I think a guy like you suits her a lot better than Igarashi.
And you're basing this on... what? His tendency to follow her everywhere and never give her a moment to herself? Yeah, I can see it.
Well, I guess Japanese women just don't know the meaning of smothered. Anyway, on his way back to... wherever, Katsuki runs into the allegedly sick Misai and tries to make her feel better.
Love is like the fireworks of days long past, don't you think?
What do you mean?
Boom! You can't appreciate its true beauty until it bursts.
Like happy festival fireworks, yeah?
You're not the type to use cheesy pickup lines like that. Why don't you try saying something from the heart instead?
Let's see.
Meow. Let me tap that ass, honey.
Okay. I'm done ruining the moment now. Let's see it.
No, you're right. You just came here to do me a favor, like you said before. You're not in love with me or anything. You're just doing what you think is right, aren't you?
That's not true either.
Huh? So I guess you are in love with me after all?
I guess.
Well, that settles it.
That settles... what? Are you just in love with him now? That's a twist if I've ever seen one. Friggin' high school, man. Meow.
One awkward conversation later, and I guess they're together or something now. In fact, Misai actually asks Katsuki on a date to the Autumn Festival, which naturally leads to...
seriously. He turned out so cute, it's kind of starting to piss me off.
I take it back. Nothing naturally leads to that. Ever.
One lesbian, non-lesbian scene later, Misai's friends offer to walk Kotsky home to make up for their shenanigans, but that's when everything falls apart.
Hey, what's wrong? Stop spacing out and say hello!
I see. Are you Kasuki's friends?
Yes, ma'am.
I didn't know. Thank you for coming all this way. Make yourselves at home. You can offer him some incense at the altar if you like.
Of course, because if you're watching Clan Egg, you're not allowed to be happy. Damn it.
That's right. I remember now. The real Katsuki Shima isn't here anymore. I'm not... actually, Katsuki Shima.
Yeah, but I bet there's no way you can guess what he really is.
Well, now that Katsuki...
see what I did there?
...has remembered the real Katsuki's mission, he makes damn sure that he's gonna grant Misai's wish.
A wish?
Inside this, there's a light that grants wishes.
Maybe there wasn't anything in there to begin with.
Yes, there was. Shut up. You're ruining the foreshadowing. Anyway, since Kotsky has figuratively outlived his usefulness...
is that the right word? I mean, he's technically still alive, but he's not from this world, and even then, he's a cat spirit. Ugh, whatever.
There's only one wish that Misai can have to make matters even worse.
I wish for you to stay by my side and love me forever. Just like you said, I want you here, loving me and caring for me forever and ever. So there you have it, my wish.
What? No, nothing to see here. Back to the show.
I'm sorry, did I surprise you? I love her. I love her so much. I know we didn't spend long together, but every moment was priceless. I like you, Kiyosaki, too. All these memories. I really wish the four of us could stay together forever. Come on, why are you crying so much? I'm sorry. I really have to look after you, don't I? Misai. Thank you. Thank you so much for everything. I'm going to get something to drink, okay? I'll be right back. Shima! Oh, I don't... What are you saying? Shima, wait! Goodbye, Misai. I'm sorry. I'll do my best to grant your wish. My feelings will never fade. I love you forever and ever.
Fuck you.
I want you all to take a step back and recognize what this show has accomplished here. It took an almost irrelevant story, crammed it into a rushed episode and a half, and somehow, by a genuine feat of writing, made it into something touching and heartwarming. And we're not even done yet. After we see Misai return to the school as dorm mother with her totally not Katsuki Katsuki. Oh, jeez. As. Why am I so. Sleepy?
No, I don't! The hell? Weird, I must have dozed off or something. Anyway, where were we?
Oh yeah, that's right. At the present day Autumn Festival, Tomoya the Cat Whisperer runs into Misai where he delivers Katsuki's final message to her just before the episode ends.
I'm not surprised.
We're going home.
He probably wanted to come to this festival with you for a long time. Last night, when I fell asleep at your place, I heard him speaking to me. He said he was sorry. He wanted to stay with you until the end of the festival. He also said he'd stay by your side and love you, just like you wished. Also, Misai, there's one more thing he said. He said, no matter what, he wants you to be happy. Go figure. That's the kind of guy he is. All this time. He's been worried about you, Misai.
Worried? Well, I see. I guess you're right. He is that kind of guy.
Tomoya, I don't get it.
Don't worry. It was just a dream. I think you'd like to hear about it, though. It's a little bittersweet, but I think it's a wonderful love story.
Well, that's really... Oh! No! No! Stop!
you can hear me. I have a different master now. She's kind and sweet, smart and pretty. I love her very much. But sometimes I worry. Is this what you wanted? Did I fulfill my goal? Was I able to keep my promise to you? When you told me to grant her wish, was this what you had in mind? It's been so long, I can't remember anymore. But I don't want this to end. Please let me stay this way. Please let me be with her. I want to make her wish come true. I want to stay by her side. I want to love her and care for her forever and ever.
Well, really, there's not a lot more I can add to this. It's just great.
I can't remember the last filler arc from any show I've ever seen that worked so astonishingly well. But as I've said, it's not really filler because the story itself foreshadows events to come. So even though the plot has very little to do with the main story of the show, it's still furthering the narrative. And again, the fact that they succeeded in making me care about these characters in less than 2 episodes spent with them is astonishing. Seriously, how do you even do that?
Well, that's gonna do it for today. Next time we'll catch back up with Tomoya and Nagisa for their final adventure before the big plot plunge. So, strap in, because it's going to be a bumpy ride.